Hello friends, welcome to Spartan CRE. In this video, I'll be telling you a conceptual question. This is a question posted by Mosek Dominic. He is one of our group members in Spartan CRE. So I'll be giving Spartan CRE WhatsApp group in the description of this video. Whoever are preparing seriously for GRE can get themselves enrolled in the group. So let's get started. So this is one of the good question. There is some concept involved in this question. So before solving this question, I'll tell you the concept. Then we'll move on to this question. First of all, the question says, the figure shown above consists of a shaded nine-sided polygon. So this is a nine-sided polygon and nine unshaded isosceles triangles. These are isosceles triangles. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. These are isosceles triangles. And he is asking the angle A here. Okay, so in this question they haven't given sides values or any angle is not given here. So directly you have to find the value of A. So this is the question. So before solving this, I'll tell you a concept here. So see, suppose if you have a polygon, it need not be regular polygon, just any polygon. If you have a polygon, even this is a polygon, this is a star, five sided star. So I want to find the total internal angle in this star. So first of all, to do that, what you will do is count number of vertices. How many vertices we have here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So here we have 5 vertices. So total internal angle for this figure will be n minus 2 into gap. Gap into 180 degrees. So this will be the formula. So what is the gap here means? If you take one straight line, so to go to from one end, if you want to go to the other end, you see how many jumps you have to do. To go from here to here, you cannot go directly here. First of all, you need to go here. This is first jump. And from here to here, you have to do second jump. So you have to do two jumps. So the gap will be two here. This n will be number of vertices. Number of vertices. So here you have 3, 4, 5 vertices. So if you plug in the values here, it will be 5 minus 2 into gap will be 2 here. Into 180 degrees. So this will be 5 minus 4, 1. So it will be 180 degrees. So total internal angle for this star will be 180 degrees. So if you want to go cross check, you know, in a triangle, total internal angle is 180 degrees. So let's apply this formula for this figure. Here n will be 3, gap will be 1. Why? Because this is a straight line. So to go from here to here, just you need one jump. Okay, one jump. So now plug in the values here, 3 minus 2 into 1 into 180. So answer will be 180 degrees. So this is done. Now let's go to another figure. Okay, I will draw some random figure. Now, if I want to find the total internal angle of this figure, this is not a regular polygon again. So let's count the total number of vertices. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So we have n value will be 7. What is the gap here? Gap will be, you take any one straight line. You take this straight line here. So here to from this end to reach this end, you need to do two jumps. So gap will be 2. Plug in the formula here. 2 into 2, which will be 4 into 180 degrees. So which will be 3 into 180 degrees. So total angle will be 540 degrees. So the total internal angle for this figure is 540 degrees. Now the concept is done. Now apply this concept to the question given here. Here if you see this question, first of all, this is also a polygon. Okay, this might not be a regular polygon, but this is also a polygon. So count number of vertices. So n value will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So n value is 9. Now what is the gap here? Gap will be, you took any one single line. If I take this line, 1, 2, 2 jumps are there, 2. So total internal angle will be this much, 180 degrees. So it will be 5 into 180 degrees, which is 900 degrees. So you know now this total internal angle for this polygon is 900 degrees, right? Now you take this triangle. He said all these are isosceles triangles, right? So since this is A, now let us take this as B and this as B. Okay, now this and this are vertically opposite angles. So this will be B and this will be B, and this angle will be 180 minus 2B. For this triangle, again this angle will be B, this angle will be B, this will be 180 minus 2B. So for all the triangles here, this vertex angle will be 180 minus 2B. If you count all these vertical angles, total sum will be A plus, how many 180 minus 2Bs will be there here? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8 into 180 minus 2B. This total value will be equal to 900 degrees. Now, if you take this triangle, you know this value, A plus 2B equal to 180 degrees. Now, 180 degrees minus 2B value will be equal to A. You can plug the value here. Here you have two variables, right? So you need to have two equations to solve these variables. The second equation I am deriving from this small triangle. That second equation is this one. A plus 2B equal to 180 degrees. So 180 degrees minus 2B will be A. Plug in the value here. So total it will be 9A. 9A is equal to 900 degrees. So total A will be 100 degrees. So this will be our answer. Okay. Now, if you don't want to go by this substitution, equation we are solving, what you can do is just go by substitution. Like what you can do is, now you know total internal angle is 900 degrees, right? Total internal angle is 900 degrees. Suppose if I am assuming my angle A is 100 degrees, if I am going by options, if this is 100 degrees, this will be 40 and 40. So this will be 40, again 40, 40, 40, 80. So this will be 100. Now this also will be 100. This also will be 100. This also will be 100. So all these are hundreds. So total 9 vertices are there. So it will be 900. So our option taking 100 is right. So your answer will be A. I hope you enjoyed the video. See you with the next new concept. So guys, start posting your doubts in the WhatsApp group of Spartans GRE. As and when I find some good question similar to this, I will start posting conceptual videos. Thank you.